All right, welcome to the Bro Council interview with Miss America 2011, Teresa Scanlan. Teresa, thanks for being with us today.
Thank you so much for having me.
From what I understand, you were 11 when you won Miss America back in 2011.
I was 17 when I won. Just recently turned 20.
Well, if I was running for Miss America, I think my platform would be to get rid of mosquitoes. And probably TLC, the Learning Channel, because I feel like that used to be Learning Channel and now it's the Ladies Channel. So those would probably be my two. I don't know if I'd win on those two platforms, but that'd be it. Mosquitoes and the Learning Channel, TLC.
Perfect.
Perfect. I hear you like to make clothes out of duct tape.
Can you
tell us what that, because it's a site for guys, and I feel like duct tape clothes would, hopefully some of our viewers have duct tape clothes out there. So what is the story behind that?
Well, I started collecting and making things with colored duct tape in high school, and I just really liked it. I fell in love with it. It was kind of just a creative outlet, I guess. I started just decorating things with duct tape, covered my car on the inside with it. I would have covered the outside, but I found there's a certain heat that it can get to without melting. So I figured putting it on the outside wouldn't be the best idea. But I just started doing all these things. And then I'm pretty sure, if I remember correctly, it was that I saw the winners of the duct tape competition where you make your prom dress out of duct tape, and saw this girl had made her prom dress and the guy his tuxedo completely out of duct tape. And so I started making clothing out of it. So in high school, I actually wore my duct tape clothes. I had duct tape shorts, a skirt, a couple shirts, covered shoes, like all sorts of stuff. But, and I still have most of them.
Does the crown have real diamonds in it?
Everybody asks that, and I don't believe so. I'm pretty sure it's Austrian crystal because they have a new one every year, so it can't be like worth millions of dollars because then I wouldn't be able to keep it. So they have a new one every year. We actually, every former Miss America gets to keep her crown, so I still have mine, and I think it's great that way.
Yeah, I feel like if I was Miss America, okay, this is actually, I just realized the second time in this interview I said if I was Miss America, and I feel like as the president of Bro Council, I feel like this is kind of going to get me in trouble later on. I might be impeached, but if I was, I feel like I'd wear that around all the time. Just everywhere I went, just letting people know that I'm going to stop there because that's the second time I've said something about Miss America.
See, it's probably for people like you then that they make it that I'm not allowed to wear it anymore. After your year, out of respect for the current Miss America, you're not supposed to wear it anymore. You can hold it, you can bring it with you places, but not wear it. So it's probably in case someone like you ever becomes Miss America.
All right, so not only did I say I want to be Miss America twice, but Miss America actually called me a diva Miss America already, so that's that's great. Recent polls have shown a fifth of Americans can't locate the U.S. on a world map. Why do you think this is?
I think there's only one way to answer that question. I personally believe that some U.S. Americans cannot do so because some people out there don't have maps. So we in the U.S. need to help the Asian countries and the Iraq and the such as for our children.
Wow, that is the second best way I've ever heard that question answered. That is amazing. The next four questions were all guys asking for your phone number, so I'm just going to skip that part. So that was the last one. It was just, I kind of got sick of people just saying, hey, can you give her my phone number? I'm not going to. And for all you people that wrote in and said that, it was ridiculous questions, so we're skipping them. What is your favorite guy movie?
What counts as a guy movie?
Like Braveheart, Top Gun, Rocky, not The Notebook.
Oh, goodness. Oof. Actually, I saw Rocky for the first time not too long ago and really, really liked it. I love that movie. I think it's a great one.
Rocky, the new one, Rocky Balboa, is actually excellent, too. Beards or mustaches?
Neither.
Oh. Ooh,
no. No, not on you particularly. I'm just saying, in general, I just don't like facial hair in general, but...
Well, I appreciate you saying not me, but so far you've called me a diva and said you hate my facial hair, so this isn't going as well as I was hoping.
It works for some people. Very few people can pull off facial hair. It works for you.
Goose or Maverick?
Goose or Maverick?
I was a little worried you wouldn't. Did you ever see the movie Top Gun?
No.
Okay. If you're going to go into politics, I feel like you have to watch this movie because it involves the Air Force and the military. I'm not a Tom Cruise fan, but this was Tom Cruise before he became crazy, and it's one of the greatest movies of all time. And there's a love story in it.
You know what? I'm going to put that down on my list of movies to watch, because the issue is I just don't watch a lot of movies, and so I've got a lot that I need to watch, but I'll probably just have to write them down, make sure that I get that done.
All right. Well, I'm on the list. I still haven't seen Titanic, which now, out of principle, I don't think I ever will, but like, there's so many movies I haven't seen that... Oh, don't give me that look. You haven't seen Top Gun, so I feel like you can't judge. You can't judge me.
But if I go watch Top Gun, you have to watch Titanic.
Can we actually have a Skype hangout where you're watching Top Gun, I'm watching Titanic? It'll be great for viewers to watch 2.5 hours of us watching a movie. Before you go, I wrote a poem that I was wondering if you could maybe read to our viewers and to me. Would that be okay?
Okay.
All right. I just sent it to you there.
Let me see. Ray, I just met you, and this is crazy, but here's my number, so call me maybe. Yeah, Ray, no.
All right, well, 0 for 3. All right, so I'm a diva with an ugly beard who's not getting a phone call. Ah! Well, this is Ray from Bro Council, getting ready to sign off here. We want to just let you know, check out Bro Council. We're a clean site for men. So you'll enjoy it, and your girlfriends and wives will actually encourage you to visit it. Thank you again, Teresa, for being here. If there's anything we can do to help you out. Oh, man, see, this is... Before we went in the air, I'm just going to throw this out there to our viewers. Before we went in the air, I told Teresa that I can't end these videos. I never do it right. I always screw up. There's always... And I... Anything we can do to help you out? That was a horrible way to end the video. I don't know what we could possibly do to help you out. I don't know. If you need us there to carry your crown while you're speaking, just let us know. Apparently, that's what I meant by that.
Okay. That's good to know.
I'm just going to wrap it up by saying thank you, Teresa. Is there anything you'd like to say before you go?
Well, goodness, I want to say thank you so much. This was a lot of fun. Thanks for having me. And certainly, anytime I can come back, please feel free.
And anytime you need us to help you, you just... Give us a call. If there's something high on a shelf you can't reach, just let us know, and we, as Bro Council, will be there. So, thank you, Teresa. Thank you to the viewers for watching this awkwardness, and we'll talk to you later on. Thanks.